we have got the endocrine disruption taking place.
So you are saying that endocrine disruptors do not pose a health risk?
It is not an issue that we understand.
Hierdie storie bevat meer vrae as antwoorde.
I don't even know how it feels like a woman, how it feels like a man.
Estrogen mimicking activity.
I don't want to be any.
It is not a health issue.
When you give birth, they can't wait to hear, is it a baby girl or is it a baby boy? And what had happened to my parents, obviously I was born with both genders. A biological term is an ambiguous child.
Die Makatso Sebiri is op 1 April 1983 in Baragwanath Hospitaal gebore.
My dad thought, you know, they were just making a joke because it's the 1st of April. He thought, no, there's no way I'm born that day.
Sy het die eerste 6 jaar van haar lewe in die hospitaal deurgebring en het 'n hele reeks operasies ondergaan om aan haar 'n geslag toe te ken.
I left the hospital, I think at the age of 6 or 7. So I knew nothing. I knew I was in hospital, I knew something was wrong with me, but I didn't know what was wrong with me.
Wat fout was, is dat sy met die toestand bekend as intersex gebore is. Ongeveer 1 uit elke 2000 babas word na beraming met hierdie toestand gebore.
Are there specific areas where more people are born intersex?
One area was Northern Cape and the other areas was in Northwest. And we also found that in Botswana there is quite a large number of people who are born intersex.
Tebogo Nkuana is 'n aktivis wat daaraan werk om die aanvaarding van intersex gemeenskapslede aan te moedig. 'N Saak wat in die media deur die bohaai rondom Caster Semenya na vore gebring is.
When the issue of Caster Semenya came forward, we had our own leaders, you know, saying things like there is no intersex in Pedi, you know, so that says a lot. You know, it also gives us an idea that this is an issue that it is really not well known about.
Met bitter min inligting oor hoe om die situasie met hulle baba te hanteer, moes haar ouers die moeilike besluit maak. In die Makatso se geval was hulle besluit dat sy 'n dogtertjie sou wees.
My mom said when I came back from hospital, the first thing I wanted was a bicycle and a gun. And she said she realized that from there that I think they took the wrong tool.
Haar kindertyd was ondenkbaar.
I remember when we having family gatherings, it became a norm for me that when someone comes to me and say they want to see something from me, I didn't understand why they even called that part a private part, because to me, I never had privacy.
Navorsers glo dat die Makatso se toestand moontlik deur omgewingsblootstelling aan iets genaamd endokriene versteurders veroorsaak is. Dit is grotendeels vir die blote oog onsigbaar.
In a complex organism like a mammal, which humans are, you've got millions of cells doing different things. And central to this is a process control mechanism called the endocrine system. So the endocrine system is almost like your very basic computer program that controls other very complex functions.
Professor Anthony Turton is 'n onafhanklike omgewingswetenskaplike wat navorsing oor die invloed van besoedeling doen.
So the endocrine system controls what happens to cells, how they function over time.
To put it simply, endocrine disruption we could describe as being anything that affects the hormone system.
Bettina Genter, 'n senior navorser by die Wetenskaplike en Nywerheidsnavorsingsraad, het 'n omvattende studie oor die impak van endokriene versteurders gedoen.
So the endocrine system is basically your hormones, and then with the disruption you're talking about how it can affect, and it's typically thought of as negatively affect the hormone system.
Hierdie versteurings kan kankeragtige gewasse, geboorteafwykings, aandaggebreksindroom en ander ontwikkelingsafwykings veroorsaak. Nou enige stelsel in die liggaam wat deur hormone beheer word, kan deur endokriene versteurders van streek gebring word.
Daar is duisende endokriene versteurders aan ons bekend, en dit sluit farmaseutiese middels, industriële chemikalieë, plaagdoders en besoedelingsstowwe in. Dit sluip op verskeie maniere in ons liggame en die omgewing in.
We're still trying to find out where the majority of exposure comes from, and I focus on what comes through water, but obviously it could be through air, through food. We are discovering that it can be certain chemicals that are endocrine disrupting can be bioaccumulated or biomagnified in food. So you're using the water to water the vegetables or the food. I mean, you can have fish that are grown in water that has got the endocrine disruptors in it, and then it ends up having the bioaccumulation is that the fish itself or the vegetables have a far, far higher concentration what the original water had.
'N onlangse studie deur die VN dui daarop dat 20% van ons drinkwaterbronne met endokrien verstuurde chemikalieë besmet is.
But having done a lot of the risk assessment work then and trying to understand it from a perspective of where we know from other studies where something is safe or a level where things are safe from our drinking water, I would say we're in a pretty good situation. When it comes to the natural environment, we're in not such a good state because we have all the wastewater treatment works that aren't functioning properly.
Professor Turton blameer ook ons swak rioolstelsels.
Because we now have a situation that we've got an extreme drought, we've also got system dysfunction at municipal levels. We've got many, many wastewater works that are hydraulically overloaded or not functioning at all. And then we've happened to be so water stressed that we actually have to recycle that water through plant that was never designed for that purpose. So in many ways we've got almost a perfect storm that's brewing.
Volgens die Departement van Waterwese se eie groen druppel verslag wat in 2014 gepubliseer is, is 'n derde van ons rioolstelsels in 'n kritiese toestand en stort dit endokriene versteurders wat moontlik skadelik kan wees in ons waterstelsels in. Sommige plaaslike kenners glo die syfer is dalk selfs hoër. Volgens Sputnik Ratau, woordvoerder vir die Departement van Water en Sanitasie, is hulle in samenwerking met die munisipaliteite besig om hierdie probleem aan te spreek.
Is our ailing municipal infrastructure part of the problem?
It is an issue that we are dealing with on an ongoing basis. So ailing and aging infrastructure is a concern from that point of view. But the issue of the endocrine disruptors is a new science. It's something that is there, but we are still in a research phase.
Nou is baie moeilik om op hierdie vakgebied vas te stel presies wanneer en hoe mense en diere wat aan endokriene versteurders blootgestel word, geaffekteer word.
Op hierdie stadium is dit moeilik om feitelike bewyse te lewer. Maar daar is 'n toenemende hoeveelheid internasionale bewysmateriaal wat daarop dui dat endokriene versteurders die kern van 'n hele aantal gesondheidsprobleme is, sommige ernstiger as ander.
It's things like obesity that is being caused by endocrine disruption, as well as things like behavioral changes where you have increased anxiety, you have aggressive behavior in females. ADD is also potentially something that can be caused by endocrine disruptors.
Aan die ander kant van die spektrum het navorsers wat studies op diere gedoen het, bevind dat endocrine verstuurde chemikalieë verwoesting in die baarmoeder kan saai.
You have a variety of different chemicals that can mimic estrogen, just as a one example. And your body can be exposed to that, and it will either then switch on estrogen, so the receptors in the cells, it can be switched on, and you would then have feminized males, or you could end up having almost indeterminate sex where the male hasn't developed to the male, and it's been a female almost, female looking. It can be extreme.
Vir mense soos Dimakatso beteken dit 'n lewe van geweldige vrees en stigma.
You know, going to church all the time, I remember there was one of the pastors that actually said people like me are like animals. I hated my life. I hated being me. You get I couldn't understand why God would just let me live if I'm going to be, people are going to look at me and say you're demonic.
Dimakatso is openlik interseksueel en sy is in 'n lesbiese verhouding. In sommige kringe is dit nie net 'n omstrede keuse nie, maar 'n lewensgevaarlike een. In haar gemeenskap is 6 van haar vriende oor die afgelope maande wreedaardig vermoor.
You know, I always wondered that there's a word homophobic. It means when straight people either are disgusted or have a phobia of homosexual people. But I always wondered why that word exists, because we are the ones that's supposed to be or have phobia for straight people.
Ten spyte van toenemende bewyse, hou die departement van waterwese se woordvoerder vol dat daar geen gesondheidsrisiko is nie.
I just want to be clear. So you are saying that endocrine disruptors are not posing a health risk?
It is not at that stage yet. We are still working very hard on our research. We have had our Water Research Commission doing studies over time, but like I'm saying, it is not a health issue at the moment.
Kenners waarsku dat daar geen Suid-Afrikaanse wetgewing bestaan om ons teen endokriene versteurders en hulle moontlike verpletterende gevolge te beskerm nie.
Typically, the testing for endocrine disruptors in South Africa, and I think the rest of the world at this stage as well, is research-based. We still aren't able to say water boards should be testing for this on a routine basis because it's just too expensive and too few people have got the facilities.
The compliance monitoring and enforcement people look at anything that might be negative according to what the National Water Act dictates. That is where we're working from.
But not specifically endocrine disruptors?
Not necessarily that, because that may not be the only thing that is in there. So we can't go in there and say we are only looking for endocrine disruptors. When we do tests, we're looking at the health of that water sample in its entirety.
In its entirety, including endocrine disruptors.
It cannot be excluding.
Kenners skets 'n kommerwekkende prentjie wanneer dit by ons land se gesondheid kom. Hulle glo ons sal kort voor lank die gesondheidskostes in miljarde rande moet bereken.
The future health of the South African population, I think it's an added burden. We have a very highly vulnerable population, and then on top of that, it makes it them more vulnerable to the endocrine disrupting effects. So I would say that we have got a problem. Yeah.